Hello dear students, welcome to mathematics class. In this class, let us discuss with abelian group. So already we know the definition of a group. So here it is the definition of a group. A non-empty set G with a binary operation star is said to be a group if it satisfies the following laws. The first one is closer law, that is, for all AB belongs to G, it implies A star B belongs to G. Then associative law, for all AB C belongs to G, then A star B star C is equal to A star B star C. The third one is identity law, for all A belongs to G, then there exists an element E belongs to G such that A star E is equal to E star A is equal to A. So then that small e is the identity element of the set G. Then inverse law. For all A belongs to G, there exists an element A inverse belongs to G such that A star A inverse equal to A inverse star A is equal to E. So if all these four laws satisfied for a non-empty set G along with the binary operation star, then this G is called as a group under the binary operation star. Now here, abelian group. Abelian group means a group is said to be an abelian group if it satisfies commutative law, means a non-empty set G with the binary operation star is said to be an abelian group if it satisfies five laws. First one, closure law, associative law, identity law, inverse law, and then commutative law. So here it is the definition, abelian group. A group G star means here already this G star is a group, means already it satisfied all the four laws, closure law, associative law, identity law, and inverse law. Then this group is said to be abelian group if it satisfies commutative property with respect to the same binary operation, that is star. So here we have some examples for abelian group. The first one is set of integers is an abelian group under addition. So here we have already proved that the set of integers is a group under addition. For that we have satisfied the four properties, that is closure law, associative law, identity law, and inverse law. Then along with that, if we satisfied the commutative law under addition, then we can say that the set of integers is an abelian group under addition. Then the second one is set of real numbers is an abelian group under addition. The set of non-zero real numbers means the set of real numbers in which zero does not exist. So that is the non-zero real numbers is an abelian group under multiplication. Then here fourth roots of unity, they are 1 minus 1 I minus I, is also an abelian group under multiplication. Then cube roots of unity, they are 1 omega omega square, is an abelian group under multiplication. And then in the set of real numbers are minus 1, means the set of real numbers without 1. And the binary operation star is defined as A star B is equal to A plus B minus AB. Then R minus 1 with star is an abelian group. Here star is defined as A star B equal to A plus B minus AB. Then Q plus means the set of positive rational numbers along with star is abelian group, where star is defined as A star B is equal to AB divided by 5. So these are some examples on abelian group. So let us solve one by one. So here it is the first example. Show that the set of integers z is abelian group under addition. So here the set of integers can be written as z equal to 0, plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, plus or minus 3, and so on up to infinity. Means the set of integers contains 0, positive natural numbers, and as well as negative numbers. So therefore, that z equal to this set. Now, to show that z is an abelian group, so first we need to prove that this z is a group. So if it is a group, then if the same group is satisfied the commutative property, then we can say that z is an abelian group. So now here, the first property is closure law. Now let us consider the two elements A and B which are in the set of z. Then it implies that A plus B belongs to z. So here the binary operation is addition. So in the general definition of the closure law, it is A star B. But here it is A plus B. We know that the sum of two integers is again an integer. So therefore A plus B is an integer. Then it implies that this A plus B is also the element of Z. So therefore for all A comma B belongs to Z, it implies that A plus B belongs to Z. Then we can say that closure law satisfied for the set of integers. Then associative law. So here we know that addition is associative for any set of numbers. So here the set of numbers is z, that is a set of integers. Now let us consider the three elements A, B and C belongs to z. Then A plus B plus C is equal to A plus B plus C. So therefore associative law satisfied. Then the third one is identity law. Let 0 belongs to z, because we know that 0 is also an integer. So 0 belongs to z, that is 0 plus a is equal to a plus 0 is equal to a for all a belongs to z. Because if you add 0 to any number, then the number will not change. So therefore 0 plus a is equal to a only, hence this 0 is the identity element of z. Then inverse law. If a belongs to z, then minus a belongs to z, because in the set of integers we have both positive and negative numbers. So therefore if a belongs to z, then minus a belongs to z, such that a plus minus a is equal to minus a plus a is equal to 0. Because if you add the negative number and the positive number, then you are getting 0 as the result. And this 0 is nothing but identity element of z. So therefore minus a is the inverse of a. So it implies that every element has an inverse. So by considering all these four properties, we can say that z plus is a group. Now let us prove that whether it is an abelian group or not. So along with these four properties, we need to satisfy the commutative law. So here to prove the commutative law, we need to consider the two elements. Let a comma b belongs to z. Then it implies that a plus b is equal to b plus a, because we know that addition will follow the commutative law. So therefore a plus b is equal to b plus a. Then it implies that commutative law satisfied. So here all the four laws satisfied, then z plus is a group. Along with four, this commutative law also satisfied for z. Therefore z plus is an abelian group. So it is the conclusion. If z satisfies only four properties, then it is simply a group. Then those four properties satisfied and also commutative law satisfied, then we can say that the given set is a abelian group with respect to the same binary operation. The next example is, show that the set of real numbers is abelian group under addition. So here the given set is capital R and the binary operation is addition. Now already you know how to prove that capital R is a group under addition. So for that capital R, we need to satisfy the four properties: closure law, associative law, identity law and inverse law. Now here for closure law, for all x comma y belongs to R, it implies that x plus y belongs to R, because the sum of two real numbers is again a real number. So therefore x plus y belongs to capital R, therefore closure law satisfied. Then associative law, for all x y z belongs to capital R, it implies x plus y plus z is equal to x plus y plus z. So here addition is the binary operation, then that will follow the associative property, that binary operation addition. Therefore associative law satisfied for the set of real numbers. Then identity law, for addition 0 is the identity element and 0 belongs to the set of real numbers. So therefore we can say that for all x belongs to R, there exists 0 belongs to R such that 0 plus x equal to x plus 0 is equal to x. Therefore 0 is the identity element for capital R. Then inverse law, for all x belongs to R, there exists minus x belongs to R such that x plus minus x equal to minus x plus x equal to 0. So therefore inverse law satisfied. So here all the four properties satisfied, then R plus is a group. Now we need to show that the same set of real numbers with the addition is the abelian group. So already it is a group, that we have proved. Then along with these four properties, we need to satisfy the commutative property, commutative law. Now let x comma y belongs to the set of real numbers. Let us consider the two real numbers x and y, and also we know that addition is the binary operation, then it will satisfy the commutative property. For that we need to write that x plus y is equal to y plus x, because if you add x and y or y and x, the sum will be same. So therefore x plus y is equal to y plus x. This implies that commutative law satisfied. Therefore R plus is an abelian group. So therefore here we have proved that the set of real numbers under addition is an abelian group. The next example is, show that the set of non-zero real numbers is abelian group under multiplication. So here we know that non-zero real numbers means the set of real numbers except 0. So therefore that is R minus 0. Now the first property is closure law. Now for all x comma y belongs to R minus 0 means for any two non-zero real numbers, means x is not equal to 0, y is also not equal to 0, then if you multiply x and y, that is x into y, then that is also non-zero, because both x and y are non-zero real numbers. Then it implies x into y is also non-zero. So therefore it belongs to R minus 0. Hence closure law satisfied. Now the associative law, let x y z belongs to R minus 0. here x, y, z, all the three are non-zero real numbers, then it implies that x into y into z equal to x into y, z. Therefore, associative law satisfied for the set of real numbers. Now, the identity law for multiplication, one is the identity element and that one belongs to the set of non-zero real numbers, that is r minus 0. Now, for all x belongs to r minus 0, there exists 1 belongs to r minus 0, means the set of non-zero real numbers, such that x into 1 equal to 1 into x equal to x, means if you multiply x by 1 or 1 by x, the product will not change, means whatever the number you are multiplying to 1, you will get the same number as the result. So therefore, this 1 will act as the identity element for r minus 0 under multiplication. So therefore, 1 is the identity element. And the fourth one is inverse law. For all x belongs to r minus 0, non-zero real numbers, there exists 1 by x. If x is non-zero, then we can define 1 by x. That is also a non-zero real number. Such that x into 1 by x equal to 1 by x into x equal to 1. So therefore, here we can see that 1 by x into x means we are multiplying this x by 1 by x and we are getting the 1, which is the identity element of r minus 0 under multiplication. So therefore, this 1 by x is the inverse of x. So therefore, inverse law satisfied. Now, all these four laws satisfied, then we can say that r minus 0 under multiplication is a group. Now, we need to prove that this is the abelian group. For that, let us consider the commutative law. Commutative law, let x comma y belongs to r minus 0, and also we know that multiplication is commutative, means you can multiply the first number by the second number or second number by the first number, then the product will not change. So therefore, it implies that x into y is equal to y into x. Therefore, commutative law satisfied. Commutative law satisfied. So therefore, this the set of non-zero real numbers is an abelian group under multiplication because it satisfied all the five laws which are necessary to abelian group.